How did you begin as a designer?
Well, firstly, it's record covers that got me into graphic design. I didn't know what graphic design was until, you know, I bought a record which I loved, and the cover, there was some strange relationship between those visuals, the cover, and the music. And if the visuals were good, it made the music better somehow. And it's the first time I thought that there's some kind of spiritual thing going on in design or painting that I could relate to. So it was really the album cover that got me into graphics. So, and it ended up when I used to copy all the band names perfectly, you know, typographically on my school exercise books. So it seemed like it was the area for me to go into. Mm. And coming from a working class family, there wasn't really the thought that you could be an artist and survive, so it tended to be a more commercial area that people went into, although of course it's not actually necessary now. So that's the reason for being a graphic designer. So,
you've put in a lot of work to get there though, haven't you? Been a lot of time.
You mean generally, or
just generalise for the moment?
I think if you want to do good work, then you have to work hard. It sounds quite boring, and a lot of people will say it, but really, if the creative process isn't difficult, then there's no point in doing it, because you should tear something out of your, it may sound a bit ridiculous to say it, you should tear something out of your soul when you're creative, and that actually pushes you forward as a person. So easy work, you learn nothing from. So good graphic design, like good music or any good creative work, takes a bit of pain, really. So, and people probably think it's quite unusual to talk about graphic design in terms of pain, because they do think of it as a commercial discipline. But you know, when you're doing something for a band you like, there isn't the consideration of this is a product to sell. You know, like a record cover or a CD cover. It's more about I love this music and I want to express it well, and I want to touch people who like that music as well. And for me, graphic design is also a thing that communicates to a lot of people. It doesn't have the pretense of things like a painting where people go into a gallery and study it. When you get a bit of graphic design, you just immediately react to, you don't think about what it is, you react to the content. You know? So I find that quite an attractive thing. It doesn't have a pretense of a value. It's very much about a message to lots of people.
I mean, creativity, people don't like to see it that way, but creativity is a spiritual work anyway, somehow. You have to go into your own personality, otherwise you're just going to be duplicating other people's work or something like that.
It's absolutely true, and I think, especially with something that people can regard as a job, they try to compartmentalise. And any good creative person, there isn't a divide between their private world and their public world and their working world. It all goes into the same pot and it comes out in different ways. I think it's very important to try and have some honesty in your work in that way. Of course, in graphics you do often have a client, so there is the balance of the logic of getting over a client's message sometimes, but obviously there are lots of different parameters in graphics. There's a record covers, plus there's a, you know, some people design tins for beans, labels for the, you know, it's, there's lots of different kinds of areas of it. So,
actually, that's this, a nice cover.
Yeah, this is the, it doesn't actually have the CD in, but it's it's the almost 12-inch version of the Heathen cover. And it was something nice in producing design this big, cause it's very physical. You can open it and you understand something about the artist because something is revealed to you. And the name of the album was Heathen, which means anti-religious, so the people often ask why the title's upside down. It's trying to say anti, very simply. You can still read it, I believe. And it's playing with the convention of the record cover as well, in that you have the artist and then you have the title underneath. So to put it upside down is subverting that idea, I think. And also we didn't put his name on the front as well, because it's one of the few people who are so famous, you don't need it. So it's a very simple cover. And this image, it's actually based on some images I found in an academic journal, which is real paintings have been desecrated. And it was this combination of beauty and violence which is inherent in this image, which we tried to portray in the design of the cover. Because Heathen, somebody's anti-religious, it's that tension of established authority, but it always must have something subvert it to make it move society along. So that was what we were trying to say in these images.
It's very gothic, isn't it?
It is. I mean, the album was...
The inner cover, yeah. The inner pieces are very gothic.
The album was a lot more down than the albums he'd done before. So I wanted to reflect the atmosphere. I mean, that's what a record cover...
Mm.
That's what when they did them well, they absolutely captured the atmosphere of the music. So yeah. I hope that's what I did. And you noticed all the text is crossed out. So it's like it's the same as the defacing of the painting. It's about the denial of meaning or something sacred, because when words are printed, they tend to be more sacred.
Yeah.